Sorry, you're gonna hate this menu, dude.
Right.
Well, all it is we've got Rocky Mountain oysters. You got fish pie.
They're not
traditional fish pie.
Matt, they're not really oysters, Matt. They're not really oysters. Their oysters are actually cow's testicles.
The what?
Cow's testicles.
Are they really?
Because if you had cows.
Adam, are they really
because
testicles?
If you had.
Well, yeah, I'd eat a cow.
Get some for the middle. I reckon we should
just. I don't want a whole meal in the middle
or something.
Normal
meal.
Or something. And just like a bowl of testicles.
Bowl of balls.
A bowl of balls.
There's such a huge ball, man.
Look, that's absolutely right.
Actually, it looks quite nice.
Shut up, Fletch. Okay. I'm gonna get some sauce. Take away the taste.
Ready? Go for
ready?
It. Off three.
One. Two.
Three.
It's gonna spew. It's gonna spew.
Did you want to say so?
Ah!
Do you know what? I think it's
fine.
Worse.
It's fine. Do you know how it tastes like? Do you know how it tastes like dumplings? You know, in stew.
Oh, I don't like dumplings. Okay, Charlie.
Go on, Charlie. Be a man. Go on, Charlie.
What is this sauce?
That sauce, I don't know. One, two, three. Eat.
Go. And chew. Chew. The joke is chew. Charlie, eat it!
Oh, Jason. I just thought about it for a minute. I was like, I'm not eating a cow.
Charlie.
That's sick. At least I put it in my mouth.
Yeah, what's up, man? You alright?
I'm starting to miss home a bit, you know? Being away for so long. I'm not, if we were out of the country for more than a month, I kind of start to miss Camilla and stuff.
Get a bit homesick.
Exactly. I'm not used to being away from my friends and family so long.
Oh, I know. Well, why don't you get Camilla out here?
Yeah, I asked her if she could come out, but she said she couldn't get time off work. This is, like, really busy.
Yeah, but she might just be saying that because she can't afford the ticket. If she could get the time off work, would you like her to come out?
That would be wicked.
Yeah, all right, well, give her a call later or give her a call tomorrow or whatever and just see if you can get her out here. Because I don't want you unhappy. An unhappy Charlie is not good for Busted. We want to break this country. We don't want to, like, fail. You know it's all important anyway.
Yeah,
all important stuff. But I've got work to do, so...
Thanks,
if you need me, mate, just come and see me.
Thanks a lot, man.
We'll sort it out.
That'll be awesome. Cheers, mate.
See, a lot of people think Charlie's just being moody, but just because he really misses his girlfriend, Camilla. She's his first love, so he normally gets a bit down when he hasn't seen her for a while.
Are we still in Texas?
Yeah.
We're still in Texas.
I think so.
It's like Groundhog Day.
It does feel like Groundhog Day, doesn't it?
Every day here, though.
The amount of travelling we've been doing in the last few days, we could have actually gone up and down the whole UK probably four times.
What's from Texas?
Jessica Simpson.
Hey, somebody loves you in Texas.
Wait, who heard Jessica Simpson's version of Robbie Williams' Angels?
I know it's really not nice, man. The thing is, I watched her programme the other day, and I thought she came across a really lovely girl. And I thought, yeah, you're really nice. And I heard her sing Angels, and I was like...
Have you heard it, James?
You've totally Mariah carried it up, man, and made it.
Let's face it, Robbie's version is amazing.
Copyright laws say that you can't perform someone's song in a public place, but you're allowed to release it and ruin it.
Lads, could you imagine if you lot don't break America and then someone else covers What I Go to School For really badly and it becomes a huge hit?
The stupidest thing I ever heard.
Matt, how you doing, Matt?
Fernando.
Good to meet you.
James.
Hi, James.
Fernando.
Welcome.
What's up, man?
And Fletch, the manager.
What's up, Fletch?
Fernando Ventura.
Is this table as big as Texas?
Yes.
So, Fernando, what'd you think? I think you're putting me on the spot, man. I mean, these guys come in out of nowhere, and I'm supposed to tell them no? I mean, what am I supposed to do with three white guys from England? I mean, right now, this is not the radio station that starts off a band like that. It's just not how it is at the moment. I mean, the Nelly song leaked today. How come you don't have that in your hand?
I come here to see you, and you want to talk about Nelly.
I can't play that band until they're top 10, and that's it.
Surely we should be going places that are going to play our record, not places that are going to play a hip-hop tune.
Thanks for flying all these miles. Thanks for flying 5,000 miles. No, seriously, you've got to remember that a place like Texas is the size of the UK. Let's put things in perspective. You're the second most added behind Good Charlotte.
This sounds awesome.
Yeah, that's good.
Out of the 120 radio stations in America and all the rejection we got a third of them in today. That's 40 out of 120. Sirius Satellite came in. Tulsa even came in.
Hey, you guys. Oh, how's it going, man?
Hi, Dave. You all right, mate?
Hey, man. David.
Sorry I'm late. I was just upstairs in my room, but I wanted to come straight down because I think with the ads coming in right now,
yeah.
And people kind of knowing busted, like when we say busted to people now, they're like, oh, busted, as opposed to before it was like, who?
No,
but you know, with the ads coming in, I was talking to press and you guys are off the bus.
Yeah, that's good.
Check this
Hallelujah.
Out. Check this out. You guys are going down. You guys are going down to Miami Beach to go to the MTV Video Music Awards.
Because I watched that last year. That's a really good show.
What are we doing? Just
getting
hanging out.
We're not real sure yet, but we know for sure you're guaranteed to walk the red carpet.
It's that important, though, because in the UK, it's kind of seen as a bit tacky if you're unknown walking down the red carpet.
Honestly, the UK means nothing here right now. It's all about the American guys watching them on the American show going, they belong on our American radio.
Damn that's right.
And the best part of it is, I'm not going with you guys.
Well, either. Okay.
I'm getting on a plane and I'm going home.
I mean, the guys are used to winning major awards. They've won Brit Awards, and they're used to performing at these things. So it's going to be kind of weird then walking up the red carpet for no real reason.
I was just about to come in so you can get some off work.
Oh, great. Oh, that's really awesome. Good.
We're going to Miami after this?
Yeah.
Because I checked the flights, and there's one that flies out this afternoon that she can get to Miami this afternoon. But would it be all right if I left this afternoon as well?
You want to go this afternoon?
Yeah, is that possible?
That should be fine. I'll call Adam. You go and get yourself ready, because if you're going to have to go, you're going to have to go soon.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Go and get yourself ready.
Awesome, cheers, dude.
Well, that's really good.
Is that my taxi?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Hello?
Hey, it's me.
Oh, hi. How's it going?
I'm doing good. What's up? How are you doing?
I'm not too bad. Well, yeah, I'm fine.
Listen, I checked my schedule, and since we haven't seen each other, like, in ages, we have loads of downtime in New York, and I thought I could get you a plane, and you could meet us there.
Ridiculous in all people skills. In all humanic skills. You just can't ring someone and invite them somewhere when you have shown no respect, really. You haven't spoken to me, so I haven't.
I'm speaking to you now. Tell me about it now.
No, James, I can't talk about this because. Ring me and ask how I am for once.
Okay.
I love the fact that you most of the time act like a singer. Most of the time it's really funny, but. I want to be an adult, okay?
I didn't plan on, Hello?